Hallo, hier ist der Deepstar. Willkommen zurück zur nächsten Bashai-Folge von Elves of Dead Extinction. Diesmal behandeln wir die 6. Mission der Mühen-Kampagne. Das heißt, es ist auch zugleich die letzte Bashai-Folge für diese Kampagne, weil wir uns mit der letzten Einheit beschäftigen. Das ist der Exosuit. Die Statistik seht ihr wieder hier. Die normale Statistik und die Upgrade-Statistiken, damit ihr genau wisst, was das für eine Einheit ist. Und ich auch, aber was die immer brauchen, keine Ahnung. Mal gucken. Description: The Exosuit is a micro-scale heavy armor solution, bringing the offensive and defensive benefits of larger combat vehicles to the individual soldier. It is designed for heavy assault in difficult environments by combining staggering firepower with a range of integrated protective systems. Default weapon: Twin M103 Turret Cannons. By default, the Exosuit comes equipped with an M103 Turret Cannon attached to each arm. These weapons are linked and work together to saturate a broad firing arc with projectiles. When a Turret Cannon attacks, it initially fires at a moderate rate and covers a small arc but spins up until it absolutely blankets a large arc with its firepower. Those enemies not amply protected often lose their full freedom of environment as they struggle to survive the onslaught. Okay. Characteristics: Compound Armor System. The Exosuit protects its operator with a suite of integrated systems. First, it has compound multi-layered armor that enable it to deflect lighter projectiles outright. Second, its integrated anti-NBC nuclear, biologic and chemical systems permanently protect its viewer from a range of alien afflictions, including spores, cysts, virulence, acid scarring and facehugging. Third, the system is largely impervious to radiation and fire. Upgrade: solid-state cannons. The Exosuit upgrade replaced the mechanical Turret Cannon with an electrocannily triggered projectile array known affectionately as the Bullet Box, a grid of railguns that comes pre-filled with bullets. These railguns can fire simultaneously and with sufficient frequency to launch multiple projectiles before their predecessors have even left the barrel. The result is a weapon that fires nearly 1,000 rounds per second, RPS, a volume of ordnance sufficient to liquefy most targets within seconds. Strength: the exosuit fire rates enables it to suppress and shred large numbers of enemies, making it particularly useful against melee attackers, since they have a hard time closing inside the weapon's attack cone. While it does not fire armor-piercing rounds, the exosuit fire rate is so great that even heavily armored targets can succumb to it, given enough time. Finally, the suit's compound projective systems make it ideal against attackers that otherwise cause side effects on organic troops. Ugh. Man, diese Texte, ey. Weaknesses: the Exosuit's biggest weaknesses are its limited speed and maneuverability, byproducts of its heavy protective systems. Also, while the Exosuit's rates of fire makes the issue less significant than it might be, the suit's bullets have neither great penetrating power nor long range. A number of enemies are specialized for attacking heavier opponents and can exploit these weaknesses. Also, the Exosuit designers have yet to integrate the Ape Suit's recent advance towards full acid resistance. Ja, also mit anderen Worten, gegen stärkere Einheiten gar nicht so gut und er ist auch gegen Säureangriffe entsprechend nicht immun. Also ist empfindlich gegen Säure, weil es doch diesen Ape-Suit noch nicht gibt für dieses Ding, für den Benutzer von dem Teil. Ja, aber das war's mit der Bestiary von den Marines. Es geht dann beim nächsten Mal weiter mit der ersten Folge der Predator-Kampagne, also mit Predator Bestiary. Bis dahin, ja, bedanke mich bei euch fürs Zusehen und bis zum nächsten Mal.